Torah Garden, speaking the absolute truth. Torah Nation. Shabbat Shalom, Shabbat Shalom, Shabbat Shalom, Yasharal and Yahuda. Grafted in Gentiles into the body of Hamashiach, we the people of the book broadcast Shabbat lesson is going down. See, Yahuwah has called me, mandated me to wake up Yaakov and Yahuda to the quickening of the witness, right, of Yahusha and his Ruach HaKodesh, right, that gives us life and establishes us in the kingdom, right? He has called me to render this message to the nation of Yasharal as well as the Gentiles, right? Oh yeah, yeah, Yahusha has quickened, made alive the other nations, or those that he has chosen from amongst the other nations, right, to be witnesses of Yahusha HaMashiach, to bear his Besorah of truth and declare his word, right? Yahuwah's called me to do this, and this is something I just gotta do. Look, I can't take a break. I got to be straightened in this. You know, I got to go in day after day. Of course, unless he tells me not to a day. But other than that, you gonna hear this Besorah, right? And this witness of Yahusha HaMashiach has a degree of redundancy. You know, I mean, it's redundant. The message is still the same. If you're expecting to hear something new, you know, I want to tell you. Because this is the same message that all the apostles preached, right? To restore the nation of Yasharal through faith in HaMashiach. Listen, let's go in. Yahuwah, I give you praise right now in the name of Yahusha HaMashiach for the words that you have given him, that he has given unto me. He kept it, and I am keeping it. In the name of Yahusha HaMashiach, Yahuwah, I give you praise for your Besorah of truth, your Torah made flesh. I thank you for this witness. I thank you for this seal of the Ruach HaKodesh. I thank you for this seal that has established me in your kingdom. I give you praise because it has established me in your kingdom. It is Yahuwah and Yahusha in me. I give you praise. Now, Father, Abba, I pray in the name of Yahusha HaMashiach that I would not cause anyone to go astray, that I would not turn anyone out of the way. And Yahuwah, if I ever error, correct me, Yahuwah. In the name of Yahusha HaMashiach, I trust in the process of being led by the Ruach HaKodesh. I trust in the leadership, the guidance. So I ask you by your Ruach HaKodesh to take the reins of my lips and the reins of my tongue and reign. Yahuwah, speak your word through me. Speak your Besorah of truth, your Torah of truth through me. By the Ruach of wisdom and revelation concerning the knowledge of Yahusha HaMashiach, the eyes of my understanding, the eyes of their understanding being enlightened, that they may know what is the hope of their calling and what the riches of the glory of the inheritance are in them as Yahudim, as Kodeshim of saints, Yahuwah, and that you are no respecter of person, Yahuwah. All those who would receive the witness of Yahusha HaMashiach, be it Jews, Greek, barbarians, Scythians, whoever received the witness, you will receive and will not turn away. Yahuwah, I praise you right now. I thank you for the desire to return to the land that you have established for your people. Yasharal and Yehuda, the kingdom of Yahuwah in Jerusalem, Yahuwah in Africa, wherever that may be, I declare that the desire of myself is to make it to Jerusalem in the name of Yahusha HaMashiach. Yahuwah, let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight this Shabbat. Yahuwah, I pray that you would speak through me in the name of Yahusha. I pour myself out in a vessel. A vessel to be filled up, a vessel of righteousness established in the witness. Yahuwah, I thank you. I thank you in the name of Yahusha HaMashiach. Let the words of my mouth, meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight. Yahuwah, my strength and my redeemer. Listen. This is about the witness. This is about the Masorah and the Torah of truth. This mystery that has been hid because it's only revealed in the Ruach HaKodesh. Right? This mystery is only revealed to those who have received the Ruach HaKodesh, the witness of Yahusha and Yahuwah. Listen, this is the Masorah of truth. Yeah. And you listening to Yaakov Yahuda Gaol, Yahuwah's guardian, his Torah guardian, his redeemer, his kinsman redeemer of the brethren, and the avengers of all unrighteousness. Yahweh, I give you praise. Listen, man of Yah, woman of Yah, listen, we trying to get home. We trying to get home. We trying to get home. This is the destination. Listen, this is the destination. And on this Shabbat, we about to go in. Listen, we love Yahuwah. We love his word. We love the Masorah of truth. We love the Torah of truth. We love the word of Yahuwah. And by this word, we have been renewed, strengthened, quickened, made alive. Jerusalem, by none other than Hezekiah. I don't know the rights to this music. We want to go back home. Hallelujah. We going in. Man of Yah, woman of Yah, listen. You know that Yahuwah has called me to bring to you this Masorah, this message of what it looks like to be in the witness of Yahusha HaMashiach, to be a part of, to be a recipient of his words, and how they quicken by the Ruach HaKodesh, how we are made alive in order to declare this Masorah to those who have an ear to hear in the name of Yahusha Mashiach. Listen, we're in Acts of the Apostles. And this is what it looks like. This is what the witness looks like, right? This is what the witness looks like. Right. These are the signs that follow those who have received the witness. Right. And Yahuwah is not a respecter of persons in this witness. This is not a Yahudim exclusive club witness. Right. This is not a Yasharah only inclusive. A Yasharah only exclusive club. Right. This message, this witness is for those who have an ear to hear of the Yahudim first and of the other nations. Listen, this witness is for all those who have an ear to hear and who would receive the Masorah, the Torah of truth. Let's go in, right? So, you know, we left off at Acts, the 15th chapter, the 35th verse. And, you know, we understood that, you know, Paul was confronted in the 15th chapter concerning his message and how his message did not include his disciples receiving the act of circumcision on the flesh, the seal of circumcision, right? And how they had to have it in order to be saved, you know, because there was some Yahudim came up from Judea and into Antioch and started to declare unto Paul and Barnabas and the people that in order to be saved, they needed to be circumcised, right? Well, you know, Paul had to go into Jerusalem and meet before the elders and put to them this question and have a discussion in reference to whether or not this applied, right? And in the end, we understand that, you know, that Yahusha HaMashiach's witness, right? His seal of the Ruach HaKodesh, if Yahusha has given it to you, has automatically established you in his kingdom because that seal is a seal that establishes your heart. And if you have been established in your heart because Yahuwah knows those that are his and have received the witness of Yahusha HaMashiach, the baptism, the blood, and the Ruach HaKodesh, then you have the seal. you are part of Yahuwah, right? And though the nation of Yasharal and Yehuda, the nation of Yasharal, were mandated and commanded by Yahuwah through Avraham first, who received the promise not having been circumcised, but he received the promise and 30 years later was circumcised, right? This sign, this seal, was to the nation of Israel to establish them as the people of Yahuwah, right? But it had nothing to do with establishing their hearts. They received the seal because they believed in Yahuwah, right? They believed in Yahuwah. But just because they had the seal was no guaranteed that they believed in Yahuwah. Because once the children of Israel, who was had circumcision, came out of Mitzrayim, 40 years, they all died in the wilderness, right? And they had the seal. Everybody had the seal. Everybody was circumcised except those who were brought up after them, right? During the time that they were in the wilderness, during the time they wandered, right? They didn't even circumcise their kids, right? Which is a testament to the fact that they didn't believe, right? And Yahuwah said, you know, this generation didn't believe, right? And they were going to die in the wilderness because of their unbelief, right? But the whole idea was that circumcision was a seal. It was something that Yahuwah gave to Avraham that was to be passed down throughout our generations to establish us as the people of Yahuwah and Elua, right? But we also know that Yahusha HaMashiach's witness, right, with the Ruach HaKodesh, reveals the mystery of salvation. The salvation of Yahusha is through the salvation of the nation, and to everyone who would receive has to come through Yahusha. It's not just the coming through a circumcision, right? But you have to receive Yahusha witness. And for those who have never received circumcision or a law, and if they have received the witness of Yahusha HaMashiach, which for all intents and purposes is everything that you need, because it's a fulfillment of what was original. So now you have a people, a nation of nations of people that are not Yahudim, but have received the witness, right? And then they went through the whole debate about it. And Peter had drawn reference to, of course, the fact that, you know, that he had brought witness to the Gentiles in reference to the Besorah of Yahusha HaMashiach, how Yahuwah called him the head of the church to go in to the Gentiles and to establish this witness to them, and how they received the Ruach HaKodesh just like they did on the day of Pentecost, which solidified the fact that Yahuwah had chosen them among, he had chosen some amongst them to be a part of this witness, right? And because he did, you know, they were established, right? So by the time we get to the 35th verse, we have an agreement, right? The agreement is that, you know, we can attest to the fact that we're not going to put any more weighty burdens on the Gentiles. They ain't going to have to be required to receive circumcision, you know, because they've received the seal of Yahusha HaMashiach's witness in the Ruach HaKodesh, which is the seal, right? Which is the only way you will enter into the kingdom anyway. They've already received it. So why should we put any other weights on them, right? Why should we try to keep them and have them do some things that, you know, that we weren't even able to do, right? So they came to the conclusion, right, that what was necessary was that, you know, that, where is that? That they would abstain from idols, right? They would abstain from idols, anything that had to do with idols, eating meat offers to idols, but anything that had to do with idols, because he says up earlier, he says, you know, that you would keep yourself from idols, right? So the requirement was that they would keep themselves from idols, right? And that they would also, that they would abstain from pollution of idols, that they would not practice fornication, that they wouldn't eat, things that were strangled, and from blood. So, you know, they didn't drink blood and they didn't eat things that were strangled, right? Those were the law requirements, right? Which again is, see, when you understand the purpose of the law, because the law was given to reveal sin. Sin is a transgression of the law, right? So because sin is a transgression of the law, there has to be an atonement for sin to justify an individual, free him from the consequences of the law, right? Now, sin is a transgression of the law, but see, when Yahushua HaMashiach's witness is received on the inside of you, right? You now have Yahuwah and Yahushua on the inside you, the Ruach HaKodesh of truth, and now you can't sin, right? Because Yahuwah and Yahushua's Ruach and the Spirit lives in you, right? So you don't need a law, even though you'll keep the law, you'll keep the commandments. But it's not like you need the commandments because you're going to do what is right by Yahushua HaMashiach and Yahuwah because of his Spirit in you, the Ruach HaKodesh. Now listen, if you can sin, you don't have the Ruach HaKodesh. If you can continue to sin and lust and do all of that stuff, you don't have the Ruach HaKodesh. You don't, because the Ruach HaKodesh is the Spirit of Yahuwah and Yahushua and Yahuwah Elua in you, right? Therefore, you cannot sin. Paul said you cannot sin, right? You cannot practice willful sin, right, with the Ruach HaKodesh in you. You cannot do it, right? Therefore, right, there's no need for the law, right? Even though the law is there, and even though you keep the law, because you're going to keep the law, that doesn't mean that the law is done away with. It just means that because of the righteousness of you, who in Yahushua, the seed of you who are in you, right? You know, you don't worry about the law or the keeping of the law because you're going to do it, right? You ain't going to eat anything unclean because you and Yahushua lives in you. You know that ain't right to eat, so you ain't going to do it, right? You ain't going to fornicate, right? You ain't going to commit pornonia. You ain't going to commit adultery. You're not going to commit lesbianism. You're not going to commit homosexuality. You're not going to have incest with your sister or your brother, or your close family member. You're not going to have sexual intercourse with animals. You're not going to have sexual intercourse outside of marriage. It's adultery. It's all pornonia. It's all a violation of Torah. So, and when he says not to violate Torah, listen, you don't violate Torah. You keep the commandments because it's in you to keep the commandments. The witness of Yahuwah and Yahusha is in you. It abides, remains, continues, and dwells in you. Therefore, you cannot willfully practice sin. Right? You ain't going to sin because Yahuwah's Ruach is in you. Yahusha is in you. So, of course, you know, disciples came to a conclusion. Right? And Paul and Barnabas, they went back to Antioch, of course, after having received the word, right? And Paul sent Silas and he sent another, not Paul, but the apostles from Jerusalem sent Silas and Barnabas with Paul and Barnabas to Antioch and wrote a letter to the assemblies at Antioch, stressing what they have concluded with regards to having to receive circumcision, right? So, right, you don't have to receive it. It's not a mandate. It ain't something that we commanding, right? We're not commanding that you be circumcised, right? But the command to not be circumcised was not a denial of keeping the Torah. It was Yahusha. It was the fulfillment of Yahusha's witness, and how the witness of the Ruach HaKodesh is now a seal to everyone, and everyone has to receive this seal. Whether you receive the seal of circumcision or not, you have to receive that seal. And Yahusha set his approval. Yahuwah set his approval on the Gentiles, because they received the witness of Yahushua HaMashiach, not because the commandments, right? The commandments couldn't keep us. Because we needed the Ruach HaKodesh in order to keep the commandments. That was the mystery. The mystery was that Yahuwah knew that we wasn't going to be able to keep the commandments, right? But he had to give us the commandments. Because he had to let us know sin. And he had to hold us accountable to the sin that we do, right? But we understand and recognize that Yeshua is in Yahushua HaMashiach's witness. And having received the Ruach HaKodesh. So, Paul carried this message, and Silas and this Barnabas. Anyway, him and Silas, right, came and they carried the message, right, to the church at Antioch, right? And then we find out that after they had been there for a minute and they went over everything, Silas remained, right, in Antioch, right, to continue to teach, teach what is right amongst the Gentiles, right? And this Bar person, he went back to Jerusalem, to Judea, right? He says, Justice and Silas, being prophets also themselves, exhorted the brethren with many words confirming them. So he exhorted the brothers to do what is right, to keep themselves from fornication, right? Keep themselves from idols, right? He exhorted them in this, right? And he confirmed the word of Yahushua HaMashiach. He confirmed the words of the apostles, right? He confirmed the words. And after they had tarried for there a space, they were let go in peace from the brethren unto the apostles. So after they had tarried and ministered and did what they did for a space and time, they were let go, right? And they went back to the apostles, right? Notwithstanding, it pleased Silas to abide there still. So Silas decided to stay. He decided to stay. And Justice, right, went back, which is that Bar, Barabbas, I think. It pleased him, yeah. It pleased him, right, Silas to remain, and Justice went back, right? He went back to Jerusalem, right? And Paul and Barnabas also continued in Antioch, teaching and preaching the word, the Besora of Adonai Yahusha. So they continue to preach and teach the Besora of Adonai Yahusha, right? In Antioch, right? And many others also. So you have Paul and Barnabas preaching the word of Adonai Yahusha with many others also. So, you know, you had other people along with Paul and Barnabas that was teaching and preaching the Besora, right? That were demonstrating signs following. Because that's what it looks like. Right? Having received the witness, you're going to give it out. Right? Now we get ready to go into the second missionary journey, right? Starting at the 36th verse of Acts 15 chapter, right? And some days after Paul and Barnabas, let us go again and visit our brethren in every city where we have preached the Besora of truth to see how they are doing, right? So they decided it was time to go back to the places that they were before, right? Second time, to find out how they were standing in the truth, right? Right? And Barnabas determined to take with them John, whose surname was Mark, right? Right? But Paul thought not good to take him with them, who departed from them from Famolivia, and went not with them to the work. So Paul, right? Barnabas like, okay, let's go. I'm gonna take with us John Mark. Paul was like, nah, he can't go. Because, you know, he didn't stand with us the last time. He can't go. Paul thought it was not good to take him. Paul said it ain't a good idea to take John Mark. Listen, understand this, right? Right. And this is the truth, right? As men and women, we are to be led by the Ruach HaKodesh, right? And you know, it's hard at times, and this is how I see this particular set of events that occurred. Because now what you have is Paul and Barnabas having an argument over whether or not John Mark should come, right? And as Hebrews, right, Yahuwah calls us and puts in us his Ruach HaKodesh. And we have to be led by his Ruach HaKodesh, right? The earnest of our inheritance, the seal, right? The Ruach HaKodesh of truth, right? Even as men with the Ruach HaKodesh, we are at times influenced by how we feel, right? Right, how we feel. Because, you know, to be perfectly honest with you, there was a point in which I felt like, though I knew Yahuwah had called me to Yasharal and Yehuda, right? And I knew that the Gentiles were included in this overall quickening, right? I felt like I needed to reach my people. My people, right? And though in a sense there's substance to that, there's reality to that, there's also the understanding that the Ruach HaKodesh had to help me to understand that there's no distinction, right? The message of the Besorah has to be preached, right? It has to go to the Gentiles and to the brethren, the Hebrews, right? Right? And you know, you can find yourself in dispute with the Yahudim over this, right? And, you know, they feel like, you know, it's what we should do. You know, it's what we should do. We should be trying to bring our people in. Right? It's what we should do. Right? And I clung to that ideology as well. You know? But Yahuwah says to me, no, listen, no. The witness of Yahushua HaMashiach and having received the Ruach HaKodesh is for everybody who has an ear to hear, who I've chosen. You can't discriminately make a decision based on what you feel. You can't make a decision on what you feel. See, because, you know, your emotions have to be in subjection to the Besorah of truth and the word of truth. It has to be. Right? Because see, if you don't let the Ruach HaKodesh lead you and guide you into all truth by the Besorah, the Torah of truth, then you're going to be ruled by your emotions, because your mind, your soul, your nefesh is unregenerative. I mean, it remembers everything, right? And what keeps you in the place of this soundness of Ruachal mind, right, is your dedication to Yahuwah's Ruach HaKodesh and his Torah and his Besorah of truth. And how you literally have to fast and pray to bring that under subjection, right? Because, you know, it's a real part of us, right? you know, Paul was his own man, right? He was still Yahuwah's man, but he was Paul, right? And Barnabas was his own man. He's still Yahuwah's man because Yahuwah said, you know, set aside for me Paul and Barnabas for the work that I have for them. They were both anointed. They both had the Ruach HaKodesh, but they didn't always see eye to eye at times. Right? Does it make either one of them wrong? No. Right? Does it sometimes affect unity? It can. It can. Right? But the idea is that you have to allow the Ruach HaKodesh to keep you, your heart and your mind in Hamashiach, Yahushua. You have to let the Besorah and the Torah of truth mix with the Ruach HaKodesh of truth to keep your heart in mind, because otherwise, you know, you can have a contention that springs up into a root of bitterness and cause yourself to be set apart. You can allow a word of truth, right? And you know it's a word of truth, to set you up to a place where you feel a certain way about someone and you feel compelled that you just got to leave them. You got to split. You got to do your own thing, right? And it has nothing to do with the Ruach HaKodesh. It has everything to do with you. Paul thought it not a good idea to take him, because, you know, he left before. They got ready to strike out on a missionary journey, and John Mark with him to a degree, and then he went back to Jerusalem. That's his prerogative. He could do that. He may have felt like he needed to go back to Jerusalem for a time before he strikes out on the missionary journey. Paul saw that as a failure. He saw it as a failure. He said, no, I'm not taking him with me, because he didn't endure last time. I'm not doing that. He can't go with me. No, he was like, he can't go with us. Right? He can't go with us, right? So let's look at this, because this is important to understand, right? You know, Yahushua's called me to deliver the Besorah of truth the way that I deliver it, right? Because, you know, he has different administrations, different operations, right? Same Ruach HaKodesh, right? He has people that will hear me that won't hear somebody else, right? I mean, that's just the way it is, right? So here we have Paul thought it not good to take John Mark with him, who departed from them from Pamphylia and went not with them to do the work. So why are we taking him with us before? He went with us to do the work first time. Oh man, listen, you gotta understand. There's this degree of us that's still us, right? Still us. Yes, we have the witness of the Ruach HaKodesh. If you have the witness of the Ruach HaKodesh, you've made alive in Yahushua Mashiach, and Yahushua lives in you, but you're still you, right? And the you that's still you doesn't necessarily mean that's the sin part of you. It's just what's you. It's just you. It's just you, you know? Paul had no tolerance. Paul felt that, you know, you left when we got ready to start the work. And, you know, you don't know what Paul was thinking. You know, Barnabas was like, yeah, okay. It's okay, no problem. Go do what you got to do. Paul was thinking like, you know, why you don't want to go do the work, man? You know, but you got a problem with the Gentiles? You know, now all of a sudden you don't. I mean, listen, this is all speculative, but the idea is, is that there's reasons and motivations behind the things that cause us to make decisions. Sometimes they have nothing to do with the Ruach HaKodesh, but has everything to do with us. This is why we have to be led by the Ruach HaKodesh. Even a man like Paul, even a man like Peter, right? Well, there was a time when Paul was sitting down to eat with the Gentiles and Peter was with him on the missionary journey. Right. And when some Yahudim showed up, Peter and Barnabas both kind of pulled themselves away as if, you know, we ain't eating with them. Now, here's Barnabas that have already received the witness. He understands the Gentiles. Right. And then Peter, you know, he was the one that stood up and you know, look, man, men and brethren, look, these Yahuwahs already said da 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 da, you know. That these there's no respect to person, right? But now, you know, you got some religious Hebrews that have showed up to this feast and, you know, they all getting funny. And Paul put them on blast. Yeah, he did. Listen, we're gonna get there. We're gonna get to that one too, right? We're gonna get to that one. Let me see if I can find that real quick. The idea is that there are things that make us at times that, we have to come to grips with, right? All right, let's go on. Let's do this. Where am I at? Acts. Let's do this. Let's finish this one and then we'll go tie them together. He says, so, and the contention was sharp, right? Acts 15:39. Because Paul was like, no, the contention, right? The contention, let's look at the word contention in the Greek. Irritation.
Strong's G 3948.
Paroxysmas.
Paroxysmas. Paroxysmas.
Praskusmas. Listen. It means an exciting excitement, an irritation. You know how brews get excited and start raising their voices of contention. Oh, man, what's the etymology of this word? It means to make sharp, right? To spur on, to irritate, to provoke, to arouse to anger. To scorn, to despise, to provoke to anger. Listen. Them brews got mad. Now listen. This shows, right? This really demonstrates how important it is to be led by the Ruach HaKodesh, right? Because we not only see what this looks like, we also see what.
Cut it out, go down. Now go.
No! My 130-pound mastiff hits the fence sometimes. Intimidating. It ain't necessary all the time. So, yeah, bring her in. So, what you have is brews that have a contention, right? And it was sharp. Let's look at that Greek Hebrew word for sharp.
Strong's G 3948.
Same word.
Paroxysmas.
Same word.
Paroxysmas.
So paroxysmas, right? So they had a contention that was sharp, that was angry. Come on, man. You know how we Brews get, right? Now, this says now, where is it at? I'm looking for something. Oh man. Having a hard time finding it. I know what I'm looking for. I'm having a hard time finding it. All right. So here we have these Brews that have this sharp contention, right? Now, the Ruach HaKodesh, this is what it looks like, right? Right? Moving and operating in the Ruach HaKodesh, right? Being led by the Ruach HaKodesh, this is what it looks like, right? Right? But this is what it looks like also when you don't move in the Ruach HaKodesh. When you don't pray and make a decision, but you move on what you think and feel. See, because Ruach HaKodesh will have you to do something that's opposite of what you think. It'll have you do something opposite of what you feel. Right? So now these Brews had a sharp contention. They got angry over whether or not John Mark should be allowed to participate in an evangelistical ministry, missionary journey. Right? And the contention was so sharp between them that they departed asunder from one another. You know, now listen. They departed asunder, right? Which suggests that the separation was a contentious separation, right? That separated them. Asunder is almost as, let's look at that word asunder, right? It is to separate severe, right? To separate oneself or depart from severe, apart severe, to part severe, or to part to some, to part asunder. That's how the word is in the
group. Strong's G 673. Apachorizo.
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 Apachorizo. Right? And that means to separate, to sever. To separate, to sever. Right? Separate, sever. Right? Let's look at this. Let's look at the etymology of this word. The etymology of the words apo.
Strong's G 575. Apa.
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 It means to separate, right? To separate. Departing or a fleeing. Separating a part from the whole, right? Right? Creating physical distance, right? Now, it says, any kind of separation of one thing from another by which the union or fellowship is destroyed. Union or fellowship of the two. That's not the Ruach HaKodesh. Here's the brothers, right? They have the Ruach HaKodesh, right? But allow the Nefesh, right, to interfere with the journey. Because no doubt they would have all been stronger together, right? Because a three-strand cord is stronger than a one-strand cord or a two-strand cord, right? They would have been together and united. And even in the same place, in the same city, they still could have had preached and teached and did different things in different places in that city to reach more people. But listen, no small contention, right? Because listen, what can happen is bitterness can set in. That's why Yahuwah says, the scripture says, be ye angry and sin not. Don't allow yourself to be angry to a place of sin. Don't allow yourself to be ripped asunder, right? And not recognize, right, that you need one another. Don't do it, right? So here we see it, right? He says, and the contention was so sharp, right? Angry that they departed, they were ripped asunder. Severe, right? From one another. Severe. They left one another. And so Barnabas took Mark and sailed to Cyprus. Barnabas went his way. He said, I'm going to take Mark. Now, Paul chose Silas and departed, being recommended by the brethren into the grace of Elohim. So the brethren said, listen, don't you go by yourself. Take Silas. You and Barnabas got into a heated dispute. Barnabas took Saul, right? Because, you know, everything is in the mouth of two or three witnesses, right? You do everything in the mouth of two or three witnesses. Everything that you do is established that way. You know, that's why he sent the disciples out by twos. He didn't even send them out by ones. Listen. It was no small contention. Barnabas headed out to Cyprus. And Paul and Silas, they departed, being recommended by the brethren unto the grace. Hey, Silas hung back. And now Silas is headed out with Paul. Because they didn't think Paul should go by himself. And he went to Syria and Cilicia, confirming the churches. So he went to Syria and Cilicia, confirming the assemblies that he had established, that had been established as a result of the Bessor of truth that he preached. Right? There are things that make us who we are. Right? These things have nothing to do with the Ruach HaKodesh in the sense that They are who we are. But the Ruach HaKodesh in us and the Besor and the Torah of Truth should trump that. Why we have an argument? Why we have a contention? Right? Why? Why is it that it's my way or the highway? Why is it that you can't hear a word? You can't hear a word, right? Knowing that that word is true, but you don't want to receive it, right? How is it that you can allow yourself to have a contention? It's not the Ruach HaKodesh. It's not. It's not. And you have to be really careful, because even in that contention, there can be a root of bitterness that springs up. Something that causes you to listen to Hasatan and drive you deeper into this contention. And have you supersede the Ruach HaKodesh. Yahuwah wasn't pleased with that contention. He wasn't pleased with the fact that these brothers couldn't get it together. Right? But Yahuwah ain't gonna waste time. He gonna send you with John Mark, and he gonna send Paul with Silas, and you still both gonna get the work done, and down the road, hopefully you will come to your senses and find the need for one another. Acts the 16th chapter. We're gonna go keep going. And matter of fact. There is going to come a time when we're going to get in the book of Acts where you're going to see the contention that, or the disagreement that the Apostle Paul had with what the Hebrews were doing amongst the Gentiles at one time. We don't get into that right now, because we're going to get to that later. All right? So Acts 16, chapter, the first verse. Then came he to Derbe and Lystra. And behold, a certain disciple was there named Timotheus, the son of a certain woman, which was a Jewish, which was a Hebrew, so Yahudim, right? And believed, but his father was a Greek, right? So Paul now comes upon Timothy. Right? You know, Timothy became real dear to Paul. Right? Paul's letters to Timothy. Right? Now, Timothy, right? Mother was a Hebrew. Right? And she believed, right? In the Ruach HaKodesh. She believed in the witness. She received it. But his father was a Greek. That's all we know. Right? Right? Which was well reported of by the brethren that were at Lystra and Iconium. So here we hear about this Timothy, right? His mother was a Hebrew, a Jew, a Jewish, right? Which means Yahudim. She was of the nation, right? She was of Judea. She was a Hebrew, right? And he said, which was well reported of. So Timothy had a good report in Iconium and Lystra, right? Amongst the Gentiles. Right? And he was a Jew. Half Jew, half Greek. Right? Him would Paul have to go forth with him. Right? And took and circumcised him. Because of the Jews. Now, we understand by the previous chapter, right, that if he's received the witness of Yahushua HaMashiach and the Ruach HaKodesh, right, right, that he's fulfilled the witness. Right? But Paul, right, wanted to take him with him. Right? So, he took him and circumcised him because of the Yahudim which were in that quarter. In that area. Circumcised. He said, Paul took him and circumcised him. Why? He was half Yahudim and half Greek. Why? Why? Because Paul needed to have him circumcised because he was Yahudim, right? And he knew the Jews in that area, right, would question him, right, as to the validity of his Yeshua. Because he was Hebrew and he was Greek. Right? He says, because the Jews, the Yahudim, which were in those quarters, for they knew all that his father was a Greek. Yahudim knew his father was a Greek. Right? So, Paul was like, let's circumcise you. Right? Your mother's a Brew. Your father's a Greek. So to satisfy both sides, because, you know, you are the, You would technically be a proselyte because your father's a Greek. And you'd be filling the covenant of the Torah, right? Because you are to be circumcised, right? On the eighth day, which you weren't, but you would be circumcised, which would satisfy that. And you have the witness of Yahushua HaMashiach, the seal of your Yeshua, the Ruach HaKodesh. This was wisdom. Paul was operating in the Ruach of wisdom. This is not Paul making a decision to show partiality. It wasn't like he was saying, okay, yeah, you got to be circumcised because, you know, you Jew, you Greek, you got to be circumcised. No, that's the Ruach of wisdom. Paul dealt with the proselytes in that area and the Jews that were together all the time. Right? He dealt with them in the synagogues. Right? They were the one that greeted him. Come on, man. Come on. Now listen. Everything that, you know, now there's some things that, of course, you know, he had an argument with Barnabas, and you know, that was some no small contention. But look, this is the Ruach. This is the Ruach HaKodesh movement, right? Because it looks like this, right? The Ruach HaKodesh looks like this. He came and he got with Silas. I mean, him and Silas came in and he ended up finding Timothy and he wanted Timothy to go with him, so he had to circumcise him. But he circumcised him because he knew what Timothy would be dealing with. And you know, the Ruach in Paul also knew that Timothy was going to eventually, because of who he was and how he was, probably be a leader. He knew that Timothy needed to satisfy both sides of the fence. y'all don't hear me. He needed to be able to go into the synagogue, right? Because he kept Torah. Ruach HaKodesh kept the witness of Yahushua Mashiach, the Masorah. Right? He had a good report of those that are in Iconium and Lystra. He had a good report. Right? Paul would have him go forth with him and took him and circumcised him because his father, because of the Jews which were in those quarters, for they knew that his father was a Greek. Yeah. He was circumcised because his father was a Greek. And as they went through the city, they delivered them the decree for to keep that were ordained of the apostles and the elders which were at Jerusalem. Paul says, you got to go with me. But you're going to be circumcised. You're going to be circumcised. Me, Silas, you're going to be circumcised. Right? It's going to satisfy everybody. The witness of Yahushua Mashiach is already in you. Right? It's already in you. You've received the witness of Yahushua Mashiach. It's already in you. They're already speaking about you. But you need this Abrahamic covenant. You need the seal in your flesh. Right? Because they know your father's a Greek. Your mother's a Jew. Hebrew. The Ruach in us, we gonna move in the Ruach of wisdom. Because it's going to satisfy everything and everybody. And you're going to be able to do things here. Because we understand, right? See, we're gonna read the letter to that the apostles had, and the letter speaks of the need for not to be circumcised. And they gonna know you're Greek, right? But you gonna have received the witness of circumcision because you know your mama's a Jew too, Hebrew too. Yeah, you gonna be above reproach. You're going to be above reproach. Oh yeah. You'll be above reproach. See, they're going to recognize the fact that you circumcised, which means that you are a proselyte. They're going to accept that. Because the only people they accept in a synagogue like that is the proselytes. And then you are received the witness of Yahudim, so you know you can go to the other nation. You can go to the other nations. Right? And bear this witness. Just trying to position you in the Ruach HaKodesh, using wisdom, the Ruach of wisdom. And listen, now you understand too, right? Now it says, now listen, man, listen. And as they went through the cities, they delivered them the decrees for to keep that were ordained of the apostles. You know, have nothing to do with idols, fornication, things strangled, and the drinking of blood. Right? Which is really keeping the Torah. Because, you know, they're going to keep Shabbat. Because that's what they did. They kept Shabbat. Ain't nobody didn't keep Shabbat. That was just what they did. They kept Shabbat. Right? They did. And they learned as they were taught what was required. How to be obedient. That's why Paul sent letters. That's why the apostles sent letters. Listen. Ordained of the apostles and the elders which were at Jerusalem. Right? And so were the churches established, so were the assemblies established in the faith and in the witness of Yahushua Mashiach. And increased in numbers daily. Look, these brothers preaching the Bessor of truth. These Gentile churches were increasing daily. But our Hebrew churches ain't, our Hebrew assemblies, what they doing? Our Hebrew assemblies, are they increasing? Are they increasing daily? Is your assembly still got that same 20, 30 people? It drops down and then goes back to the same number and goes up, drops down. What are you doing? Are you out there with the witness of Yahushua HaMashiach? With the signs following you? Establishing these ministries, establishing these people? Establishing these strengthening these assemblies. You doing it? You doing it? Strengthening and establishing these ministries. You doing it? Establishing these assemblies. Are you doing it? Missionary journeys, are you doing it? Right? Are you satisfied with the number of assemblies you have? Oh, yeah, I'm putting a number of cap on assemblies. No. You should be still out there reaching. Still should be preaching the Bessor of truth with signs following. You should be going and telling some of these Gentile assemblies. Because this is what it looks like. The number should be increasing daily. This is what this looks like. See, this is not me. This is what it's in here. Yahuwah said, this is what you got to tell them it looks like. This is what it looks like. It's what it looks like. What it looks like. It looks like. Numbers should be added to the assembly. It's what it looks like. And then in the assemblies, you by the Ruach HaKadosh and in fasting and praying are laying hands on people to send them out so they can go reach people. To establish the assemblies. Listen. Truth be told, right? You know. Dura. See. We would have our assemblies and our assemblies only. Nobody else's assemblies. Our assemblies and our assemblies only. Can't live like that. That's not the message of you. That's not the message. That's not the witness of Yahushua Mashiach. It's not the witness. It's not the witness of Yahushua Mashiach. It's not the witness of Yahushua Mashiach. The witness of Yahushua Mashiach is to establish men and women in the witness. To establish men and women in the witness. And that means to establish people in the areas of those men and women and establishing and visiting and exhorting. Listen, you just, listen, you need to have men that just going to go from assembly to assemblies with the witness of the Ruach HaKodesh and the witness of the Besorah. They're going to lay hands on people. That's going to make sure that they receive the witness, the baptism, the blood, and the Ruach HaKodesh. That's what this is about. This is what this is about. As they went through the cities, they delivered them the decrees to keep and to ordain of the apostles and the elders which were at Jerusalem. No new strange doctrines. The Besorah. The Torah. That's doing the work. That's establishing the ministry. That's establishing the church. Not church. Church establishing assemblies. That's establishing what Yahushua has called us to do. This ain't the church. The church ain't doing this. The church ain't doing it. You know what? I'm going to tell you something else too, right? You know, you got the left and the right wings. The right wings, the rights are being wickened. I mean, they're being awakened. Yeah. And Hasatan is quickening them to their Christianity. Yeah, I listen to some of their radio broadcasts, just so you understand how they think. Listen. These people are waking up to their Christianity and their faith. Yeah. And everything that's not like them eventually is going to be persecuted. That's where the persecution gonna come to the Hebrews. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Just like it came through in the times of old. They persecuted us in the name of Christianity. Ain't nothing new under the sun. Right? The dragon is still going to persecute us again in the land of these captivities. Oh, yeah, they gonna come again. These right wing, the religious right, these Judeo-Christian people, right? Who believe that their Eloah, their El, has given them the authority and the power to conquer nations, to be the Lord over the universe, to rule. Nothing new under the sun. It's going to happen. Listen. This ain't that. In your assemblies, this ain't that. You better get a clue and recognize the witness of Yahushua HaMashiach. And you better get about doing his business in the Ruach HaKodesh. You better be establishing his kingdom in the Eretz. You better. Listen, the Gentiles had to receive the witness because they still had to carry the witness to their nation, to their people. Because they're going to suffer persecution for Yamashiach's sake amongst their own nation, amongst their own people. You better get a clue. You better get the Ruach HaKodesh so you can have this mystery revealed. This mystery is Yeshua. Christianity is not Yeshua. It is not the message that was carried to the nations, to the Gentiles, to Yahudim. That's not the message. That's a wicked hybrid using the Besorah and the Torah. That wasn't the message. That didn't reach the four corners of the earth. That's wicked. That same wickedness is going to persecute the nation again. I'm telling you, listen, you better catch a clue. This religious right, you better catch a clue. Oh yeah, you better catch a clue, because this religious right ain't playing. This religious right ain't playing. No. This Judeo-Christian religious right ain't playing. They're not playing. They serious about this thing. And we have to be serious about the witness of Yahushua Mashiach and establishing his kingdom in the Eretz. And so were the assemblies established. So were the assemblies established in the witness and increased in numbers daily. They were established in the witness and increased in the numbers daily, right? Now, when they had gone throughout Phrygia, and the region of Galatia, and were forbidden of the Ruach HaKodesh to preach the word in Asia. The Ruach HaKodesh don't go to Asia. Don't preach the word in Asia. They were led by the Ruach HaKodesh. Don't preach in Asia. They were forbidden. Mother Ruach, that's why, see, listen, that's why you got to have the Ruach HaKodesh, right? You have the Ruach HaKodesh. Because if you go a place where Yahuwah ain't told you to go, right? It costs you your life prematurely. Ruach HaKodesh told him not to go in Asia, right? And after they were come to Misra, they essayed to go to Bethania, but the Ruach suffered them not. See, so Yahuwah is pumping the brakes on some of these nations. So no, you don't go to Asia. You ain't going over there. Right? Right? And the Ruach HaKodesh suffered them not. Right? After they were come to Mysia, they were assayed. That word assayed in the Greek.
Strong's G 3985,
Pyrazo, right? Of Alua, let me see. To try whether a thing can be done, to attempt, to endeavor, to try, a trial, a test. So they were trying and testing to see if they could go in there. Right? Right? That's what they were doing. They were trying and testing to see if they could go in there. And to Bithria. But the Ruach HaKodesh suffered them not. The Ruach HaKodesh didn't permit them to. Right? The Ruach HaKodesh suffered. That word suffered means.
Strong's G, 1439, A-I-O.
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 Allow, permit, to let. Right? To allow one to do as he wish, not restrained. Right? But it says here, the Ruach HaKodesh suffered them not. She told them not to go. So you have the Ruach HaKodesh telling them not to go certain places. Right? Now I don't understand why they said the Ruach HaKodesh in the sixth verse, right? And said, the Ruach suffered them not to go, which is the same Ruach HaKodesh, which they chose to put the Spirit, which is still the Ruach HaKodesh, the Holy Spirit, right? So in both instances, the Ruach HaKodesh told them not to go to these places. Don't go in there. Don't go there. No, don't go in there. Don't go there. Right? Right? And they, passing by Maasia, came down to Troas. Right? And a vision appeared to Paul in the night. There stood a man in Macedonia, right? And prayed him, saying, come over into Macedonia and help us. So Yahuwah has denied them access into certain places by the Ruach HaKodesh. You don't go there. You ain't going there. See, that's why. This is what it looks like. This is what it looks like. This is what it looks like to be led by the Ruach HaKodesh. This is what it looks like. Right? This is what it looks like for you to give the witness. This is what it looks like. This is what it looks like to be led by the Ruach HaKodesh. This is what it looks like, right? And Yahuwah will cause you to receive a vision and send you on your way to where he wants you to go. Because this is what Ruach HaKodesh looks like. It's what it looks like, right? It's what it looks like. So they bypassed this Maasia, and came down to Troas. And while he was there, there appeared a vision to him at night. It was a man of Macedonia that prayed to send him, come over here and help us, right? Right? And after he had seen the vision, immediately we endeavored to go to Macedonia. I said, we gotta go to Macedonia. I know we're in Troas, but we gotta go to Macedonia, right? Endeavor to go with him. He said, we got to go to Macedonia. Assuredly gathering that Adonai has called us for to preach the Besorah unto them. Right? So therefore, loosing from Troas, we came with a straight course to Samothracia, and the next day to Neapolis. Right? And from thence to Philippi, which is the chief city of the part of Macedonia. Right? Ruach HaKodesh. Straightway. Told him to get up and leave. I don't want you in Troas. I don't want you in Maasia. I don't want you in Asia, period. I need you in Macedonia. That's what the Ruach HaKodesh does. And it's better to obey what the Ruach HaKodesh says than to sacrifice. Because when you disobey, ooh, the sacrifice is great. Oh yeah, you may end up dead. You may end up anywhere. You may end up in anything. Right? And from thence to Philippi, which is the chief city of that part of Macedonia, and a colony. And we were in that city abiding certain days, right? And on the Shabbat, we went out of the city by the riverside, where prayer was wont to be made. And we sat down and spake unto the women and resorted there. So, right? Here he is in Macedonia, right? Macedonia. Exhorting on the Shabbat, right? Now, he didn't go into the synagogue on the Shabbat, right? In Macedonia, right? Because perhaps there was no synagogue in Macedonia, right? On the Shabbat. We went out of the city by the riverside, right? where prayer was wont to be made. Where prayer was wont. So they went out to the city where they could pray, right? And when they sat down, they spoke to the women, right? They were at Macedonia. They evidently were out at the river, perhaps praying, you know, perhaps doing whatever they were doing there, right? But what we have is them doing what Yahuwah had called them to do in the city that he told them to go to, the place that he told them to go to, right? So what we get out of this is the necessity of being led by the Ruach HaKodesh, right? From Macedonia, right? From the departing to the second missionary journey, listen, you have to be led by the Ruach HaKodesh. You have to recognize that there are things that make you you. And those things have to be brought under the subjection of the Ruach HaKodesh at all times. That soul, that nefesh of you, right? Because the Ruach HaKodesh of truth and the Masorah of truth are going to lead you and guide you into all truth as you submit to them. You're going to find that in this journey, there are going to be times that you're going to have people that don't agree with you, right? But it should not lead to contention, and it should not cause you or them to sin, right, and fall into bitterness, right? And we also recognize in the 16th verse that you have to be led by the Ruach HaKodesh. You have to be led by the Ruach HaKodesh. You have to go where Yahuwah tells you to go. And, right, you have to be led by the Ruach HaKodesh of wisdom. As Paul, when he was dealing with Timothy, he understood by the Ruach HaKodesh of wisdom the necessity of having this Greek and Hebrew man, Timothy, circumcised. Because it was the covenant that was established from us, for us, as a seal that we were required to keep. But at the same time, it was wisdom that Paul was using to position Timothy amongst those who were Yahudim, who knew his father was Greek. Man of Yah, woman of Yah, understand, you have to be led by the Ruach HaKodesh. Ruach HaKodesh tell you don't go somewhere you don't go. Ruach HaKodesh told Paul not to go to Asia. It forbade him. Forbid him to go to Asia. The Ruach HaKodesh forbid Paul. Forbid is to prevent, to hold a thing from anyone, to deny or refuse them a thing. The Ruach HaKodesh denied and forbade Paul to preach, Silas to preach, Timothy to preach in Asia, in Malaysia, my Asia, and Brittany. Told them not to go there either. Paul went to Toras, and the Ruach HaKodesh, in a vision, told him to go to Macedonia, and he went straightway. He obeyed. And if anything you take away from this, it's better to obey than the sacrifice. It's better to obey what the Ruach HaKodesh is saying to you than to sacrifice. Because if you don't obey it, there's consequences. severe and extreme consequences. Could cost you your life. Man of Yah, woman of Yah, that's all I have on this Shabbat. I pray that this word ministers to you. You, who are the words you've given me, I've given them. I pray that they receive them. I pray that they keep them. I pray that they walk in the reality of them. Yahuwah, I pray that you would quicken them by your Ruach HaKodesh. By your Ruach HaKodesh, you would heal them. You would deliver them. You would make them alive. You would strengthen. You would quicken by your Ruach HaKodesh. That they would receive the entire witness. Yahuwah, I pray that in the name of Yahushua HaMashiach, that they would be strengthened by power and by might in their inner man. Yahuwah, I pray that you would remove burdens and destroy yokes in the name of Yahushua HaMashiach. I give you praise. And Yahuwah, I thank you for your Shabbat. Again, I give you praise for your Shabbat. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight. Yahuwah, my strength and my redeemer, I give you praise. Man of Yah, woman of Yah, called the great. It's the Shabbat. And on the Shabbat, Yahuwah is worthy to be praised. On this Shabbat, he's worthy of the glory. He's worthy of the honor. He's worthy of the majesty, the power, the dominion, and the might. Everything is his. He's called us to worship and to magnify him. And that's what we do. So we closing out with Hezekiah. We closing out with the Besorah of Truth, the Word, and the Witness. Hallelujah. So man of Yah, woman of Yah, called the greatness. Woman of Yahuwah, beautifully and wonderfully made today, Yahuwah has favored you. Walk in that favor. And I say unto you, Shabbat Shalom, Shabbat Shalom, Shabbat Shalom. Be blessed.
Torah Garden. Speaking the absolute truth, Torah Nation.